Welcome back to my channel. I am back again with another exciting video. So this makeup tutorial is going to be inspired from the new episode of the series called Black Mirror, and the name of the episode is Bandersnatch. And oh my god guys, it's an amazing experience. I would recommend to everyone that please go and watch it right now. It's an episode with multiple ending. I mean, you are saying what the hell I'm talking about, because this is a story where you can actually control the entire story, how it is going to happen and how it is going to end. They have an interactive session where you can choose your options. I mean, this is just a mind-blowing option. I never really seen in my entire freaking life something like this. And when I say that, because I am pretty active in social media and I am a YouTube junkie and I watch pretty much everything on YouTube, but this is something for the first time I have experienced in my life, and I would recommend to everyone, just go and watch this series. So yeah, enough of that. I am going to create something really exciting, like a pixel art, and half of the face will be like psychedelic art. So I'm not really sure how it is going to turn out. If I fail, then we'll just pretend that this video never really happened and move on. So without further ado, let's get started.
Already here with my base done, because there is nothing fancy out there. I have just applied foundation, concealer, and I have set that off with some powder. So what I'm doing is that right now I'm creating my contouring with a very dark shade foundation. This is actually from the NYX Cosmetics called Total Control Drop Foundation. I'm not sure about the shade name, but as you can see, it is really dark from my skin tone. Now this pixel art might look a bit complicated guys, but it is extremely easy to do. What you need to do is that you just basically need to do contour, highlight and blushing on your face. Yes, that's it. So here I am putting the dark shade where I usually contour, like on my forehead, and then gradually I will build up the color to a nice gradation, maybe like two or three shades lighter from this color right here, what I'm putting right now. And that way I will create my highlighters, that way I will put my eyeshadow, that way I will put my blusher. Just keep watching and you will understand what I'm doing right now. And now I'm just contouring with that same color under my jawbone where I usually put my contour. Then I switched back to my nose, and I'm doing like the half of face pixel, so that's why I'm not touching the other half obviously. And when you are creating a pixel art, make sure that you choose your brushes very carefully, because if you have a round tip brush, you are never going to achieve that sharp edges where you can actually see the boxes. So here I'm using a flat square brush, and basically this brush is actually a nail art brush, to be very precise. In the course of body painting experience, like I do not really have any professional experience or whatever, I just like everything is self-taught out here. So I just figured out that I always, whenever I used to paint my face or whenever I used to make some intricate details, I used to feel that I don't really have the right kind of brushes. So out of accident actually, I ordered nail art brushes, and for the sole purpose of doing my nails. But then I discovered they work really great when you are working on such intricate details. And speaking of highlighter, now you can see that I am using a much lighter shade, even lighter than my skin tone of makeup, and I'm applying those boxes. Now I just want to see that how I achieve this color. This one is the Kiss Beauty palette, I guess, and I don't really reach out for this palette, and it's very cheap, I would say, like it's really budget friendly. So what I'm doing is I'm just scooping out some of this white color and mmicing it up with some micellar water. This micellar water is from NYX. Now this technique I also have shown in my zombie makeup trick, that if you want to play around with the consistency of your makeup, such as liquid lipstick or your liquid foundation, or in this case like this cream foundation, you can always toggle with some micellar water or maybe like some non-oil based makeup remover. That way if you add more, you are going to get much less opacity and much liquid consistency. So this is a great technique to play around with your makeup in terms of pigmentation and in terms of texture. Another trick I would like to share with you guys, whenever you are creating pixel art like this, always keep watching and keep checking your makeup onto a camera screen, because up close when you are doing it and looking to your mirror, you might see that all the clarity is there and your boxes are very clean and crisp and clear. But when you are watching it from a distance, it is going to change some things and your makeup might appear like a little bit muddy. And pixel art is not about that. It is not at all meant to be blended, all the colors and all. So that's the fun about it, I would say. So whenever you are feeling on your camera screen that your makeup is looking too much blended or too much smooth, I would say just break the boxes by applying some random color or just applying in a contour. My eyes, I'm going to create an effect of eyeshadow as well, because I want to wear eyeshadow even if when I'm pixelated. Wow. So anyway, there is no color scheme. I'm just putting like bunch of reds and pinks and some contrasting colors such as blue and purple. And then I'll just put a nice wing to make the look cohesive. To be very honest guys, there is not much really to explain. If you watch the video carefully, you will be able to decode the tutorial, I would say. It's really simple, really easy. You just need like patience and time. So just take your time and just keep doing what you are doing, and I think you will end up looking really pixelated. Yeah. For my lips also, I'm using the same colors like blue, pink and some red. And once I'm done, I will be creating some white boxes here and there just to like highlight everything much more, because that is our actual highlighter, you can say. Like our pixelated highlighter should be also blinding. So yeah, I'm going to do that. This side of my face is pixelated enough, and for the other half of my face, I'm going to start off by sketching the bobble, like sketching those trippy kind of pattern where I want to put them. So here I'm using a felt tip liner. This again is from I think NYX Cosmetics, and I'm just outlining the trippy kind of pattern where I want my colors to be. And again I'm just referring to some pattern pictures where you can see actually how these colors are creating these patterns and everything. I really love trippy art and the color combos, like they look really mesmerizing and kind of hypnotic also, I would say. So once I'm done outlining the color pattern or whatever you want to call it, I am starting off putting some black liner. What I'm doing is I'm just thickening the line by applying that black body paint. This is not a black liner actually, this is a black water based body paint, and it's really simple. You can see what exactly I'm doing. I'm just like outlining the border, you can call it, and making it much thicker. And once I'm done with that, I am just going to lay down the colors in the same pattern, and basically you are just creating that psychedelic kind of effect. So here really I'm not using any kind of color theory, or like I didn't really plan out everything. I'm just going with the flow, like whatever color like gives you the contrast more. Now in this case, you just need to keep one thing in mind, that don't put colors which are from the same family like together. If you are putting black, then right beside put some green or yellow, because that is like very striking contrast. Don't put green, yellow and blue in the same manner. That way your art will look from a distance like very smooth and very blended. And here today, particularly in this video, we are not going to blend anything, okay? So just make everything striking and make everything popping. Yeah, correct. So I hope I make sense. And again, it's a very simple step. There is nothing to explain. You just keep watching and you will understand what I am doing, there is no rocket science behind it. I have done the same thing from my nose and from my mouth as well, as if like my nose and my mouth is actually melting to a beautiful rainbow. Like, wow. And just adding some drips here and there, and with that this conceptual look is completed. I really enjoyed the show. Guys, if you haven't watched the series and this particular episode, please go and watch it. It's an amazing episode. Like, hats off to Netflix and hats off to the content creators who come up with such kind of idea. It's terrifying, but it's harsh truth of this internet world. That was it. If you like my video, then don't forget to like, comment and subscribe to my channel. Guys, please subscribe to my channel. I really work hard for each and every video, so just subscribe, okay? I will see you in my next video. Till then, take care. Bye.